10.
Ladies and gentlemen, school is in session. Prepare yourselves for the school of Croc.
Good morning, crocodilies out there. It is Saturday morning here at Gatorland. Hope you guys are all up eating your cereal, having a great day with your family. We have a special episode today, and this episode makes me really excited because today I've brought in my most favorite pet that I've ever had in my whole entire life. I've had this kind of pet since I was a very, very young person, and I have one now for you guys. Now, thanks to everybody that tuned in yesterday and saw Athena. There were lots of questions. Remember, if you have questions, comments, want to know more, want to post pictures of your kids watching or make videos of them asking questions, you can do that in our School of Croc Facebook group. We're sharing all of that stuff to Gatorland's page. In this time right now, when you guys probably can't go outside so much, we're bringing the outside and we're bringing Gatorland to you. So today, cameraman,
we're jumping right into it. Here we go.
Here we go.
What?
I knew that was gonna happen. Oh my goodness! Today I brought you guys my favorite pet in the world. His name is Frogger. Now Frogger is a white tree frog. And he comes from Australia. There's all kinds of frogs throughout the world. And I think the oldest fossil of a frog dated at about 265 million years ago. Frogs are so incredible. And just look at Frogger.
Wow. Look at those giant toes he has.
He does. He's got four toes in the front, and he's got super long legs. Now, frogs are jumpers, if you can see. Frogger!
Oh, good catch, Savannah.
I know Frogger. He lives at my house. So frogs are amazing jumpers. In contrast to another animal we're going to show you guys in just a second. So Frogger comes from Australia. He's a really amazing little frog. Lots of people have white tree frogs as pets. They're also called dumpy frogs sometimes. And I thought that since you guys might be eating breakfast, we could give Frogger a little piece of breakfast if you guys want, if everybody wants to see that.
Oh, Hunter, age 6, wants to know, how does Frogger feel? What's he feel like?
Frogger, right now, he feels a little bit sticky. When I first pulled him out, he felt a little slippery because I had him in some water down here. Now, frogs can absorb water through their skin, and they can also absorb different kinds of toxins through their skin. So I have to keep my hands really clean when I'm playing with Frogger. Clean from, like, chemicals, not clean from, like, dirt, because dirt's okay. So Frogger eats crickets, but he also eats pinky mice. Frogs eat about anything that can fit in their mouth. So we'll try to give Frogger this little piece of... Frogger, stop! Frogs are pretty amazing. Here, Frogger, eat that. Eat some breakfast. You want it? Here, buddy. And frogs do have teeth. They have little teeny, most frogs have teeth, not maybe all of them. But frogs have little teeny teeth. Get it, Frogger. They eat crickets, they eat bugs, they can eat almost anything that can fit into their mouth. There are also frogs from Africa that are called pixie frogs, and sometimes they even eat birds. I think Frogger's just excited to be outside. I don't think he's going to eat for you guys today.
Well, Wesley wants to know how long Frogger can live.
You know, Frogger is already about 10 years old. Some frogs, I think the oldest frog that ever lived got up to about 20 years old. But around about 10 to 12 years is how long frogs usually live. And you can see he has these little sticky pads on his fingers. I'll show you guys. So he can stick onto things. He can jump onto things. Look how long those back legs are. Frogger is such a joy. He's one of my favorite animals in the world. I've had frogs my entire life. Now, there is a big difference between a frog and a toad. So we're going to go over here to Michael Brown, and he's going to tell you guys all about toads.
All right. Hey, Michael.
How we doing, guys? We have a cane toad for you here today. This is our cane toad here from Gatorland. Now, these guys were brought over from Central America, and they were brought over all over the world to control bugs and all sorts of stuff. Now, they got introduced to Australia, and they caused a big problem over there for animals like Savannah's white tree frog. they would eat just about anything, and they're actually toxic. They have a peritoneum gland right here, and they release a bufotoxin from that gland, and all toads actually have it, but this guy's is a little bit more because he's a bigger toad, so it's a little stronger. So you got to watch it. You wouldn't want to eat this guy or stick him in your mouth, but just touching him, you're okay. Wash your hands afterwards, obviously.
Now, Nora wants to know, does this guy have a name?
This is Miss Stubbs.
Miss Stubbs.
This is what, we have a couple different cane toads here at Gatorland. Now, they have 5 toes on the back, 4 toes on the front.
Yeah, let's see those toes.
Check out those little feet. And they're not really a jumper, they're more of a hopper. Even though he's got big, long legs, he's just going to hop. He's not really going to jump like that white tree frog. Cane toads are found all over the place, and they're a big, big problem now in Australia, but they're working on getting that fixed up.
Now, Michelle wants to know, is he heavy?
They can weigh up to 2.5 to 5 pounds, so it could get kind of heavy. This one's pretty mild. I mean, it's not too bad, maybe a pound. He's kind of squishy.
Oh, look at that.
And then he's kind of rock hard here. This is his backbone or his spine right through the back of him here, and it's all through there is like solid like a rock.
Oh, look at that.
And you can see all his bones here and his back and his spine.
Now, we had some people asking, do they have long tongues like you would imagine a frog or a toad would?
It's not like a chameleon's tongue where it shoots out, but it is a big, bigger tongue, and it's kind of sticky. It kind of helps them pull things in. And they do have teeth, like Savannah was saying. Toads have teeth. When you see them blink down, they're actually biting down on their little prey. They got little tiny teeth in there.
And cameraman Dan, actually, the frogs and toads' tongue is at the front of their mouth. It's not attached at the back, so that when it comes out, it has a substance on it that's a sticky sort of adhesive. So even when if they're getting a bug or if they're getting a little mouse, it tries to get away, it can't get away because of that sticky adhesive that's on there.
Now, Bryden wants to know who the predators are for this frog.
For this frog?
Mm-hmm.
Birds can eat it. Snakes can eat it. Fish can eat it. Birds definitely love to eat frogs whenever they can. I don't know about the cane toad because, like Michael was telling you guys, cane toads are poisonous.
So the cane toad doesn't have a lot of natural predators. It is one of the largest toads in the world, and most animals from where he's from know that he's toxic. That was the big problem. When it got introduced to Australia, nobody gave a memo to all of the native wildlife in Australia that this is a toxic toad being introduced to the environment. So the freshwater crocodiles were snapping these guys up and eating them, and it was basically almost killed the freshwater crocodile species over there almost entirely. It made them extinct. So that's a pretty big problem, you know, for one toad.
Wow. Now, Lori wants to know how old Miss Tubbs is.
Miss Tubbs is about 10 years old, but they can live up to 15 to 20 years, like Savannah was saying. So they do have a good long lifespan on them. They grow pretty quick from a baby, and then when they get toad size like this, they kind of stay around toad size like this forever.
Now, Barbara's asking, neither of these are indigenous here, correct?
No. These are both, well, this one is from Australia, a white tree frog, but I bought him here in the United States. They're very big in the pet trade, and I love frogs, so look how he looks very sophisticated right there on my face.
That is a fancy frog.
He is a very fancy frog. Now, the one that Michael has, actually, there are a bunch of them invasive here in the state of Florida. But they are not from here. They're from Central America, like Michael said.
Central America, and they were brought over in like 1935 to Australia to eat the cane beetle and the sugarcane industry, and they just ate everything. They're a voracious little predator, and the predators that would eat them, like birds and crocodiles and snakes, they were getting a bad kickback because of this bufotoxin. So things really didn't like to eat them too much.
Wow, very nice. These are
so
both super interesting.
So you can see the difference. Let's kind of, if you kind of see the difference between frogs and toads, don't jump, Frogger. Don't jump. And you can see how the toad's eyes are actually more football shaped, the way that they are. And then the frog's eyes are very round and bulbous.
Look at that.
And the toad is very, very dry. Where hers is kind of slippery and slimy and sticky, this guy's very dry. He's not going to be in the mud, or he's going to be in the mud, not the water.
And this guy's going to spend most of his time in the water. And here, let me dispel this myth for you guys. Frogs and toads don't cause warts. No matter what your grandma told you, that's not true. Now, toads do look very warty, Ow! Frogger! Stop! He's very excited to be outside today. But I love catching frogs. It's one of my favorite things to do. I grew up catching frogs, and they were a big influence on my life. I'm sure that's the first time anybody's ever said that. Frogs have changed my life because now all these years later that I'm a grown-up, I work on the conservation of all wildlife in the state of Florida, and we're able to do it through our Gatorland Global Program all over the world. So thank you guys for being here this morning. Make sure you post any more questions, photos, videos, anything else you have into our School of Croc Facebook group. And we appreciate you guys being here. Tomorrow morning we will not be doing School of Croc. It's Sunday morning. We want you guys to maybe stream your church service or whatever makes you feel good on Sunday mornings and spend some time with your family. But we will be back on Monday for more School of Croc.
See you tomorrow, 10 a.m., same croc time, same croc channel.
Love you guys. Bye.